So can I ask you about the film's visual style? Because obviously there is a lot of style that I think we can see carried through from your photographic work. But it also seems to me that you're doing this in a very, very cinematic way here. So could you talk about, I guess, some of your visual reference points? Because I think this is very strong film visually.
ビジュアルを作るのはやっぱり得意なので、そこは外せないと同時に、そんなに実は意識していなくて、それよりも自分が弱いであろうストーリーだったりとか演出の部分に一応すごく集中したんですけど、でもやっぱり得意なところっていうのはすごく強く出てると思います。でやっぱりビジュアルによってそのキャラクターの言葉では語れないところを語り尽くせたりとか、例えば部屋のディティールだったり、そういうところはかなりこだわったんですけれども、洋服にしてもそうですね。でそういうのはやっぱり普段写真でビジュアルの仕事をしてたので、本当に割とスムーズにできたところだと思います。
So yeah, visual aspect came quite naturally because it's my strength. And but I would say the visual aspects of this film helped building the main character without explaining it verbally. For example, seen in the details of the room and also her clothes. And so this visual set designing, it came very naturally to me.
And it's a very interesting line to tread, the line I think that you tread, because on the one hand, it sometimes feels like it is a visual culture of advertising and of the beauty industry. And then on the other hand, it feels like you're being critical of that and criticizing that. So can you talk about, you know, your artistic intent with that?
普段が本当にファッションの業界だったりとかアドバタイジングの業界にいるので、本当に表も裏も見ていて、割とその周りにはドキュメンタリーを撮ったんじゃないかって言われるぐらい、割と日本のこういった業界だと普通のことなんですね。ここまで整形している人はいないにしても、取り囲む環境っていうのはとっても似ていて、その中にいたからこそ伝えれるメッセージっていうのをできる限り込めたつもりです。
Because I'm involved in the fashion industry and advertisement in my normal career, so I know ins and outs of the industry and their environment. So some people actually said that this is more like a documentary of how the industry is in Japan. And of course, there isn't anyone who's done a full body cosmetic surgery like the character. But the environment I created in the film is quite similar to the reality. So that's the kind of message I wanted to put forward.
元々が漫画のコミックスの原作で、すごく私大好きな話で、女性がここまで美しさに執着するっていうことっていうのは、いつの時代もどの国でもおそらくあることだと思っていて、普遍的な話だと思って、やっぱりそれは女性である私じゃないと分かりきれないところがあると思っていたので、これはもう絶対私がやりたいって、結構7年間その原作の許可が下りるのを待って。
The original is actually a manga comic book, and I always liked the story about this obsession, women's obsession towards beauty. And I believe this is a very universal theme in any country, in any time of the history. And also, I thought we women are the only one who are really understand it, and I thought then I have to direct this film, and it took actually 7 years to get the rights, so this was a real wish for me to actually make this film happen.
Japan, that Japan, ってあんまり宗教のことに無頓着というか、お寺で、そうです、結婚式は教会でやって、お葬式はお寺でやるような あまりその宗教的なことっていうのに興味がないというか、無宗教の人たちがほとんどなので、割と本当にただのイメージというか、そういうふうにして使ってる人が多いんですね。例えばマリア像がいっぱいあったりとか、そういったモチーフの洋服を着たりとかするのと同じで、もう本当にただのそういったイメージで彼女も使っているのではないかと思います。
In Japan, people are not very religious, and a lot of people get married in a Christian church, but have funerals in a temple, and so people are not serious about religion, have not very much interests, and a lot of people use religious images and icons for just as an image and a design. For example, some women might have a lot of Maria on her clothes, and so this is the same idea for this main character.
すごく今回の映画は東京を表現したいなと思っていて、私は東京で生まれて東京で育ってるんですけれども、そういったことの表現の一つにもなるかなと思って、結構いろんなものが置いてある部屋になってます。
And also the sort of the mixture of the different things in the room, the design came from my wish to express the town Tokyo where I was born and grew up. So this is my message too.
まずは本当私自身が赤が好きで、自分の部屋が床も天井も壁も全部真っ赤なんですけど、それはもう本当ねオブセッションだと思うぐらい なぜかそれに執着していて、なんでかなと思うと、まあそうですね、情熱的な色だったりとか血の色だったり、あらゆることを含んでいるような気がするので、好きなのかなと思ったりもするんですけど、もう癖に近いと思いますね。
Yes, I do love red. It's my favorite color. And even my room, all the ceilings and the walls and the floors, they're all red. It's my obsession. And I think the reason... So the reason is because I think it's a color of passion and a color of blood, and it includes everything.
エボリューションは、やっぱり彼女もまたに知らない方の方が多いと思うんですけど、ものすごく日本の有名なアーティストで、すごく人気があって、消費されるほどのものすごい本当にリリコのような女性なんですね。で、一時すごく頂点極めていて、今少しこんなこと言っていいのか分かんないですけど、下がり気味だと思っていて、そんなこと言っていいのかなでもリリコのイメージと重ねれていいなと思っていて、すごく日本人にとって重要なアイコンで、彼女の生き方自体が私はすごく潔くて素敵だなと思ってるんですけれども、そこが重ねられたらいいなと思って使いました。で、渋谷っていう街にすごくとっても合っていて、象徴的だと思ったので。
So Miss Hamasaki, the singer who sang the evolution, like in, it was in your question, she is very, very popular in Japan, and in a way she's one of the consumed celebrities, and she's in a way a bit lyrical-like as well as the main actress. And I don't know if it's okay to say, I think there was a bit of a laugh from the Japanese audience, but... So, just between among us, I guess that she was at the top of the market, and now she's struggling a bit. So this was kind of the message behind it as well. And so in that sense, for Japanese audience, I think the doubling image again of the singer and the main character Lyrico in the story is very important, and the singer herself is a very wonderful person, and she's very bold, and also the song captures the image of the town Shibuya very well.